Come on.
Being bad.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. break.
Calm down, silly. It's okay, Luffy.
Thank you.
Come on. Shouldn't be doing that. That's a dog. made some money. Yeah, I believe so. It's 12. She's probably in bed. I'm gonna go to bed in a minute. I'm finishing something. Oh, hey, Germ. I'm working on a Cerberus. It's gonna be like a Furby with three heads. No, like Cerberus. Cerberus. I'm gonna sign off in a minute because I have a fucking fishing trip to go on and Dad's making a big deal out of it. This is the first Furby I started making. Its name is Tater Tot. It was just supposed to be a test to make sure that my pattern worked, but I'm sort of developing it. This is my second one. It's a dragon. It has nightmare eyes. It has little feet. I'm pretty happy with how this one turned out. I like to make more dragon furbs, and now I'm trying to figure out the furbers. It'd be nice if I could at least get the pattern pieces cut out so I can see how they fit together better. Thank you, I'm having a good time. I made, whole bucket of Furby faces. This one turned out so pretty. It turned out so pretty. I really like how the glitter turned out. It's so pretty. Yeah, I have a whole bucket of these, and I'm gonna make more. Basically, I completely wing it. The first one I made is just sort of like the basic one. I made it a little bit longer than... These are all small, of course. The actual Furbies are a bit bigger, but I'm working off like a 90s McDonald's keychain size because I don't want to work too big. Say it's materials. Also, the bigger ones are hard to find. Basically, I looked at the patterns for Furbies. I lost the one that I got this off of, the body for it. It's somewhere in my fabric, but basically they have, like, a front part and, like, the back parts, and then, and so I tried to just figure out how that would work. You know, I, like, sort of, went off, like, photos and videos of how they're constructed, figured to make a sort of, like, a little triangle thing. So this, I make two of these, and they go on either side, and then I made, like, a bottom part. And if you look at them, they have a pretty simple stitching. Like, these go on, and they have the different belly piece, which, I don't know where I put that piece. Is that it? Yeah. You know, you sew this in, and then you can sew the side pieces on. And when you're sewing these seams, the ears, I don't know where I put the ear, the ears go up here, you know, on either side of that, like, triangle, and then the feet go in the bottom and sort of attached to the front. So it's a pretty simple, like, way they do it, but I tried to just figure it out. Basically, I took the pieces of paper and I drew on them and I taped them together to try to figure it out. And now I'm basing everything else I make, like, here's some of the Dragon Furby pieces and the wings and stuff. I'm sort of basing everything else. This is the belly stripe for the dragon because it goes all the way along the bottom. Like, yeah, basically I figured out the first one, which turned out pretty good with little tater tot. I did a test first to make sure it actually worked without ears or feet because I just wanted to make sure the body worked. And then since this turned out well, I thought, okay, good, I have a good base. So, you know, now I'm basing everything else off of this. So yeah, I'm pretty much just completely just going for it and putting the pieces together, and if something doesn't work, I alter it a little bit. Currently, I have no idea how I'm going to do the bottom of this one, because it's going to be, like, kind of wide, and I don't know if it's going to be a circle or, like, a triangle. I don't even know if the pattern I have right now is going to work at all, but I'm going to see how it goes. I'm using this really sort of cheap black felt, which, like, I'd like it to be this color anyway and sort of like a fuzzy look, so if it turns out well, that'll be good. I'm gonna do a different color for the belly and the inside of the ears just to sort of see how that works out. Yeah, basically I am full-on winging it. No, come on, last. And my white gel pens betrayed me today and are not working. I'm struggling tracing up the patterns. You can work with me, please. I should just get one of those fancy sharpened pieces of chalk or something. There's some people who use, like, white soap and just sharpen it to a point. Because, you know, it washes right out. Fucker. Useless. Like, I'm not supposed to be using it on fabric, but the fact that it's not working on the material I'm not supposed to use it on still makes me mad anyway. Because it still worked the best. This is a Posca paint pen, which, I don't think it's supposed to work on felt, but they usually work really well on fabric. This one's just a little iffy because it's a fine tip, and fine tips have all of the problems. I use my regular Poscas, but they're a bit too thick for what I'm trying to do here. Come on, keep going, keep going. I do have some of those, but they clog up really easily. Like, even when I'm just working on paper. If I have to, like, if this is working pretty good now, it was fighting me earlier, but if I have to, I have some of this, which is basically correction fluid. And I can sort of like put it on with a really thin paintbrush or something. These are just so easy to work with, kinda. I'm not getting a perfect line, but it's thin enough and bright enough for what I need it for. Oh, thank you. I'm not gonna be fishing. My dad and my friend are gonna be fishing, but I go around picking up trash and occasionally I find some nice things. Last time I found a whole ass fishing rod, which I gave to my friend. Hope you have a good sleep.
Thank you.
see. I gotta sign off for now because I gotta get up and fucking do something in the morning. But, if there's anyone out there, I hope you have a good night. Maybe I should try to send y'all on to someone else. Okay, so I got two of those, I got two of those, I got this part. I gotta figure out what material I want to, cut this out of. And also I want to cut, the insides of the ears and the bottoms of the feet. See if there's anyone on whom I can raid. I think I want to do a little bit more with this face for Tater Tot. I dyed this fabric, well, by dyed, I mean, I pretty much just kind of squirted some acrylic paints into some water and diluted it down a bunch and then dunked some felt in there. I don't know how well that's actually going to work, but I'm hoping that after I leave it, go to stream manager so I can raid. Hoping after I leave it for a little bit, it'll like dry out. Even if it stiffens up because of the paint, that'll be okay because I want to chop a bunch of tiny little pieces, like little rectangles, and glue them all over to make Tater Tot look even more like a Tater Tot. Yeah. Okay, let's see who's on. I think I might want to put in little pupils and the little eyelashes, because they have, like, little eyelashes. I was also thinking of giving the dragon little eyelashes. But I don't know if I want to paint them on, or if I want to make them out of, like, plastic or paper. Okay, Crossing the Streams is playing Arkham City. Letterbag is playing Friday Night Funkin'. DC's on... Let's go bother DC. He looks like he's doing something fun. It'll be interesting to watch while I get ready to go to bed. Let's go. One person. Okay, Streamlabs is wildly off with the amount of people who are here. Oh well.